This happened on Wednesday night, and God revealed to me just so much, and I felt so alive and so amazed at what God can do through me. I was standing in front of a church. It was during a church service of about maybe 100, 120. And the church is usually 1,000. It's the middle of the week. So it was me and someone else went up there to show their testimonies about forgiveness. Just like a background. I learned forgiveness through like a youth conference called Heavy Rain. And I forgave my dad, my brothers, and everyone else who's hurt me.
Yeah.
And so I got to share that in front of the church. And after the church service, we're like, now if anyone needs forgiveness, like, come up here and we're willing to pray for you, for forgiveness, for God to touch you. And so I was amazed at all the people that came up. And so we were each assigned a translator. And then some of us weren't lucky enough to get a translator, but I was. And so we're going up to the first guy. I start praying for him, and after I'm done my prayer, God just hit him, and he just fell right to the ground.
Wow.
Don't worry, he got caught. And then I pray for the next guy, and I put my hand on him, and I was like, God, will you just reveal? And then he fell. I'm like, God, I didn't even get to finish my prayer. But okay, you know, you're doing your work. Go right ahead, next person. And I had to pray for a bunch more people. The thing that really stuck out to me was this couple. They wanted to learn how to forgive each other, but they didn't know how. And they've been together for quite a while. And so we're praying for them. And the guy, he had surgery a few days prior to coming to the church service. And it was on his appendix and stomach, and he was in a ton of pain. And so I prayed for him. And then I asked him, like, do you have any pain in your body? Does it hurt? And he's like, no, I'm 100% better.
Yeah.
No more pain. And after that, they looked at each other, and they forgave each other, and like, I don't know, words just can't describe it. Like, I got to see relationship restored.
Amen.
And like, that was through like the power of my testimony that God helped me with, you know? And I got to see God helping with other people too.
Right.
And I fell down in amazement because God's so good.
Yeah.
I did a prayer for my wife and I, and so he prayed for us. So I want to encourage you tonight. After tonight's service, Pastor Greg is going to stay up here at the front. If you want him to pray for you, he will do that. But he prayed for us, and it was a good word, and Pastor Tim shared with me how they knew each other and how they had a friendship going and stuff. I thought, oh, that's cool. And then one time when we took up the offering, we found a ring in the offering plate. A big ring. And I thought, I looked at that ring. I went, God, what are we going to do with that ring? And I felt him say, send it to Pastor Greg Gill. I went, ah. And I felt the Lord say very strongly, covenant ring. I went, cool. And so we sent that to Pastor Greg, and he was blessed, and he sent us a note back and stuff. And Pastor Pika was recently invited to go to India to preach there. And so he's going, whoa, this is kind of strange. Where is this coming from? And, you know, so he's trying to check if this is legit or not. And so he finds out Pastor Greg Gill has been there. And he's never met or talked to Pastor Greg Gill or not. It was through my connection. So he connected with Pastor Greg and said, hey, is this thing legit? And Pastor Greg shared with him about how he had been there before and had preached there before and how awesome it was. And so I just love that, how God is making. He's a great orchestrator of events and connecting people and people's lives. And so Pastor Pick is away on vacation, and Pastor Greg Gill is in Ontario. And he said, hey, Pastor Greg Gill, why don't you come down and preach at Dunamis Church tonight? And he said, yes!
Woohoo!
So we're grateful. Pastor Greg, why don't you come up here and share the word of the Lord?